Hey there, and welcome to Play Noggin. I'm Julian, your brain's player too. At Play Noggin, we like to keep it on the lighter side, filling your brains with sciencey goodness and gaming excitement, while avoiding anything too depressing or heavy. Well, except for the video about getting shot in the head. Or the one about Fallout 4 and nuclear obliteration. Or the one about how every Pokemon will kill you. Okay, we don't always keep it light, but we do keep it informative, and that's what we're going to keep doing. Today, we're talking about Grand Theft Auto V and the sorts of criminal minds that served as inspiration for the game's colorful cast. Grand Theft Auto V is one of the biggest games ever made, if not in literal size and budget, then in societal impact for sure. The series has always been one congressional hearing away from starting a culture war about influencing our children to be criminals, and it's never leaned so wholeheartedly into that reputation than it has in the fifth mainline iteration. For the first time, players are hot-swapping between three main characters, all equally capable of ramping an SUV off a bridge and into a crowd of unsuspecting brainless NPCs. There's Michael DeSanta, aka Michael Townley, the narcissistic criminal mastermind. There's Franklin Clinton, a young man who probably would have done well just to stay away from narcissistic criminal masterminds like Michael. And then there's Trevor Phillips, a textbook case of criminal psychopathy who loves chaos as much as Sonic loves chaos emeralds. See what I did there? Some motivations for crime are easier to understand than others. A person who steals to feed themselves or their family is different from a rich, middle-aged guy who steals jet skis he could afford to buy just because he's bored and going through a midlife crisis. But some of the hardest crimes to understand are those perpetrated for seemingly no reason. This is exemplified in the character of Trevor. Trevor is prone to fits of violence, and by fits, I mean bona fide rampages. When it comes to pure mayhem, he's by far the most extreme GTA protagonist. Nico Bellic from GTA 4, silent blocky guy from GTA 3, they got nothing on him. Wait, that guy had a name? And it's Claude? The link between brain function and criminal activity has been researched extensively, and today we have a much better understanding of why some criminals do the things they do. Researchers have found that people with antisocial tendencies have some significant discrepancies in certain areas of their brain, such as the dorsomedial prefrontal cortex and the posterior cingulate. One of those pieces is probably on the bottom of Trevor's shoe here. And on average, the middle frontal gyrus was 18% smaller in people with these sorts of antisocial behavioral tendencies, and the orbital frontal gyrus was 9% smaller. Another major area of interest is the amygdala. Far from being just a terrifying alien spider monster in Bloodborne, the amygdala is the area of the brain that handles fear and aggression. It's active in social situations, and in a person born without psychopathic tendencies, it regulates our emotions and gives us a proper fear response when things start to get dangerous. Researchers have found that the amygdalae of those with psychopathic tendencies tend to be much smaller and lower functioning than those without the same tendencies. This suggests that Trevor feels free to murder and rampage because he doesn't experience an appropriate amount of fear or social pressure about the consequences of his actions, or because he just seems to be immortal when he's angry. But when somebody makes fun of the way I talk, I get mad. Sure, I'm only human, but I don't burn their house down. Fear actually plays a big part in our development and the ways in which we choose to behave. A 20-year study began by testing how a group of 3-year-olds responded to fear conditioning. Electrodes were placed on the fingers of the participants, and they were then played two different tones. One tone would be followed by a loud, unpleasant sound, and the other would be followed with nothing. Researchers recorded the differences in sweat response from children and determined that some simply had a far lower fear response than others. 20 years later, these researchers determined there was a connection between those children who had not shown a fear response in the study and future criminal activity. All this research seems to indicate that our biology can, in some ways, predispose us towards certain actions or behaviors. Maybe that seems obvious in other realms, which is why I never felt bad that my 6'5" brother could dunk on me in high school, but we don't give it a lot of thought when it comes to the makeup of the brain. Not that Trevor was necessarily doomed from the start to a life of crime and a receding hairline. Okay, well, the receding hairline, yeah, but biology can be a jerk. But early detection of abnormalities in the brain can help lead to treatment that will allow the brain to function in more normal ways. The brain is actually very flexible, and it can grow and develop even into adulthood. Michael isn't off the hook, though, just because he doesn't murder people for making fun of his accent. Michael exhibits traits commonly found in people with narcissistic personality disorder. He seems chronically incapable of taking responsibility for his own actions, and he doesn't seem to understand that his decisions have an impact on the people around him. When his wife makes the perfectly reasonable observation that he hasn't been particularly helpful in raising their children, he turns it around by saying that she would have nothing if it weren't for him. This is textbook narcissism. He isn't Father of the Year material, that's for sure. Researchers have found that those with narcissistic personality disorder have less gray matter in the region of the brain known as the left anterior insula. Gray matter is material made up primarily of neuron cell bodies and non-neuron brain cells called glial cells. The latter is responsible for giving your brain the sugar rush of glucose it needs, as well as for cleaning out any excess chemicals. It might also contribute to the communication between neurons. The left anterior insula is responsible for helping us generate empathy, or the ability to feel what others are feeling. The more gray matter in this region, the more empathetic we're capable of being. Clinical narcissists have a decreased ability to feel empathy, and thus are more likely to be self-focused. So, Trevor and Michael are a couple of pretty bad guys, and even Franklin, who winds up being perhaps the most sympathetic character in the trio, is far from a saint. GTA is good at providing a cathartic escape from reality. Just keep in mind that these are bad dudes, and maybe you don't want to emulate their behavior. Even if you do somehow have access to a tank in the middle of Los Angeles, and it's rush hour, and I hate this city sometimes! Hey, thanks for watching. If you like what you're seeing, please like and subscribe. Even feel free to share it with your friends if you're so inclined. If you like our other content, we have plenty other videos for you to check out right here. And don't forget to keep on playing.